And you have been listening to LPJ's
Spreaker Radio with Mr.
and Mrs. Sweet Thang, and we thank you for joining us once again tonight.
Yes, it's been a beautiful night, and we really enjoy being with you tonight. But I'm a little in the weather tonight, kind of feeling on the bad side, but, you know, so I'm going to hang it up a little bit earlier tonight. Hope you forgive me for this, but...
Well, all they want to do is for you to give way of, so that's what's important.
But we want to thank God for allowing us to be together this time, you know, just lift his name up and praise him and just thank him for what he's done for us. He's been good to us. He's given us another day on this earth, another day. And he didn't have to do that. He didn't have to give us anything.
Yes, he gave us another day to lift his name up, to praise him and glorify his name.
None of us had to wake up this morning. We all could have just been over with. But he gave us another day. He woke us up and started us out and on our way to our jobs. He protected us too from work today. He have been good. Now, you don't know that, but he have. Because you went to work and came back safe. Nobody hit your car and tore it up and put you in the hospital, and you had spinal damage, broke your back, broke your neck. You went to work and came back in one piece. So you were blessed.
That's right, because he protected you.
He protected you. He put his angels around you. He protected your family, your kids. So you had a great day, whether you know it or not. You may not got what you thought you had should have gotten in this day, but you have been blessed. And so we just want to thank God for giving us this day, allowing us to get together this evening to praise and worship his name. We want to thank him, and we'll be back tomorrow night. Hopefully I'll be feeling better, and we can stay a little bit longer and praise him and lift his name up. But as we all do, always do, we got to say one more his promises, as we do, and then we have to always go out the right way.
That's right.
Always a prayer.
That's right. And we know that the title of the program tonight was "Will Your Anchor Hold?" And we know through Christ Jesus that it will. And we got one more promises, God's promises, and this is in 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17 through 19. Instruct those who are rich in this present world not to be conceited or to fix their hope on the uncertainty of riches, but on God, who richly supplies us with all things to enjoy. Instruct them to do good, to be rich in good works, to be generous and ready to share, storing up for themselves the treasure of a good foundation for the future, so that they may take hold of that which is life indeed. Amen.
Amen. I tell you, you heard the instructions from my Heavenly Father to a rich man. And follow that. Follow the instruction, because
it can only do you good.
It can only do you good.
Amen.
But like I say, we'll see you tomorrow night, same time, same place, ready to praise and lift up our Father's name. But as right now, we have to go out with a nice prayer. We can never leave without praying to our Father, thanking him for what he's done for us in this day. So our Heavenly Father, we come before you tonight, Father, thanking you for this day, thanking you for what you're giving us. Father, we know you didn't have to give us anything. All that you're giving us, Father, we're not worthy of it. But we thank you, Lord, for blessing us with our jobs and to and from work today, Father. You put your angels around us and protected us to and from work. You protected our kids, Father. You protected all that you have put in our hands to be a caretaker of. Lord, we thank you for that. We know that all we have belongs to you. You put us in a caretaker position to take care of it. Lord, we pray that you will help us to do the best to take care of what you were giving us to take care of, including your children, Father. Father, with your guidance, we will do our best. We know that we will, as long as we allow you to be the head of our lives and to guide us, Father. But now, Father, we come before you to kneel before you, Father, to ask you to forgive us for our sins, our hidden sins, or anything that we may have said or done, or any way that we may have acted in this day, Lord, that will be displeasing to you. We ask you to forgive us for those things. Father, we know that we have done something wrong because it's the nature of us to not to be obedient at all times, that one time or another we'll do something that is not pleasing to you. So, Father, that's why we're here before you, to ask you to forgive us for our sins. Father, we just ask you to keep us tonight as we lay our heads down to rest, to watch over us and protect us from the enemy, as well as we ask you to watch over our families and friends and our other brothers and sisters, wherever they are, Father. We ask you to keep them as well and touch their hearts and watch over their families and their loved ones, Father, and keep them as well. Father, this we ask in your holy name. We ask, Father, let thy will be done here on earth as it is in your kingdom. Amen.
Amen. Our Heavenly Father, we truly thank you for another day. We thank you for the many, many blessings that you continue to bestow on us. Lord, we thank you for your protection. You protected us as we went in and out today, and you even kept us, as we know that so much evil is all around us, but you have protected us from all of that. And tonight, Lord, we ask you to forgive us of our sins tonight. Forgive us of anything we've said or done or thought that was unpleasing in your sight. And Lord, once again, we come to surrender our hearts, our mind, and our will to you. We ask you to cleanse us, Lord, to renew our minds and renew a steadfast spirit within us. And Lord, once again, we just ask you to fill us with your Holy Spirit once again. Lead us and guide us every step of the way, Lord. We know that the only way our anchor will hold is only through you, Jesus, where we are rooted and grounded in your word, which we want to thank you for your word, which is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path each and every day. And Lord, we just want to continue to thank you for your blessings for us, finances, and how you watch over us each and every day. We want to continue to pray for those that are struggling spiritually, physically, and even mentally, Lord. We know that there's so much happening, we can't even begin to know how to pray for our country. But we can just lift them up to you and say, Lord, whatever your will is, help us to look to you, Jesus, which you are the author and the finisher of our faith. And again, Lord, we thank you for your protection upon us. We thank you for who you are. We thank you for what you have done for us on the cross. As we always want to give you the praise and the honor and the glory, help us to continue to trust in your word no matter what we are going through, no matter the darkness that continues to happen. Help us to continue to keep that trust. And we thank you tonight, Lord, for hearing and answering our prayers. And we love you with all our heart and our mind, our soul, and all our strength. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Until tomorrow night, may God bless you and take care of you. We'll see you then.
And may the windows of heaven open and pour upon you a bundle of blessings. And have a good night.